there. This is Cerise Styles with Beauty and the Beat Radio. We're here at Brownstone Bistro located at 5047 Pico Boulevard. I'm going to take you inside so we can see some of the menu items that he has. We're going to go inside the kitchen and see them prepare some of the meals. So why don't you come inside Brownstone Bistro located at 5047 Pico. Come on in. Welcome, Beauty and the Beat Radio. Your girl Cerise Styles up in here. It's a new week, new day. Got Wolfgang in the building. He's going to help
Wolfgang.
Me out with these. Wolfgang. I got the executioner.
Pierce in the building. LaRon Pierce from the Only Hip Hop Show, of course. What's up, everybody?
Oh, what's up? We got two new singles out from you.
Two new singles? What the hell?
Or at least one.
Well, one of them is the one I just released yesterday. It's actually AD and YG song. It's called A Thug. I just made
Are
an executioner.
I want to know what that word means because, you know, Tupac said it was the hate you gave us was the life part. But, you know, so what does thug mean to you?
Thug. it's so many meanings, but my definition of thug is just like...
it's
like
funny.
Like a criminal or like...
Oh.
Like gangster trying to act all hard and stuff. I don't know. It's so
and
many
so you
meanings.
Got a song called Thug, and that's not you, of course. You're an ideal, upstanding citizen.
Well, here's the thing.
What's up with it?
It's a freestyle.
Okay.
It has nothing to do with, well, the song is called Thug by them because of their gang-related stuff and,
got it.
Stuff like that.
So it's a play on the beats that you're using.
Yeah, that's actually AD song that's gonna be released on the mixtape by the way in June 10th.
Okay.
So, I thought it would be cool if I add my verse to the remix because when the beat dropped, I just started writing my verse by the way, and then I had people listen to it, but.
And they felt they went crazy. They was like, that's the one. They weren't feeling it.
I haven't got no response. The only person that responded is my brother Damon.
Uh huh.
DJ, but you know that's it, but.
So we're going to have to hear it and see what it is. It might be a, is it a hit or miss? Is it hit it or miss it?
It's up to y'all. I mean, we want to play it right now?
Yeah, let's play it right now. Let's see what it is. And then we're going to get into a little Hot Topics and get into, we got Kola Mac coming in later on. See what he got talking about. I got to wrap up. I went to the Pink Pump Affair. I got to talk about that. I want to see what's going on in the world of whatever. But let's get into this new song. Introduce it for us.
This is actually AD's song with Sari Gennari. That's the producer that made the beat, and feature YG, of course.
The
Crips and Bloods collections.
Hands.
So I added my verse for the remix. I called it an executioner remix. This is AD featuring YG and myself as the executioner remix for Thug. So go ahead and check it out.
Check it out.
League of Stars.
Sari Gennari. Sorry, J9.
You ain't never had a thug. You ain't never had a thug. Beat it all night till you had a thug. You ain't never had a thug. Bust it down for a cub. Best friend says she only wanna blow. You ain't never had a thug. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. You ain't never had a thug. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. You ain't never had a thug.
You ain't never had an
an executioner. Obliterates whole fuckers that don't fuck with ya. It's so hard to be L motherfucking P that only executes nothing but heartbeats. I'm a mixer, harness a Deadpool and Ghost Rider. I beat the pussy up cause I'm so violent. Set the ball high cause I'm the star that's rising. Building my empire in these fucking islands. Woman, I already told you that I'm a beast. Need to look in my eyes and tell me what you see. Me and you in the future rule the world. Show you off to the ground like you're my girl. So, see what I just did there. Got your smile while you're so wet down there. Feeling my style, I see you trying to front. AD already said
you ain't never had a thug. You ain't never had a thug. Beat it all night till you had a thug. You ain't never had a thug. Bust it down for a girl. Best friend said she only wanna blow. You ain't never had a thug. Wait a minute. Take you to the hood, let you cruise around the main line. Hit the blood and lick the middle at the same time. Damn, bet you never had it that way. Bring a friend, she ain't with it, send it that way. Take a loss, get it back, that's the fast way. And I can still make the money on a bad day. Wait a minute, come and fuck with a thug nigga. Only hang around them G's and the drug dealers. Look, you need a rider, not a punk. Hit a nigga line, give it to you when you want. You ain't never had a thug. You ain't never had a thug. Beat it all night till you had a thug. For a girl, best friend said she only wanna blow. You ain't never had a thug. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. You ain't never had a thug. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. You ain't never had a thug.
He ain't never had a blood. West side, middle finger, touch my thumb. My crib bitch take dick like all cubs. That's my spot on the hood. Oh, I'm in there making pornos on the mat. Show the next bitch like this where it's at. Hey, you ever took dick from the back? Fucking up your tracks. Listening to banging on wax. Oh, fashion never had it that way. Did good. Call me on a bad day. Hit the Maybach parked in the alley. What that mean? That mean a nigga doing a nasty. Wait a minute. She want a pyro gang member. She just want to fuck. She ain't even trying to hang with you. I'm a P-Funk, not a chump. My sex drive. Crazy, give it to you.
You ain't never had a thug. You ain't never had a thug. Beat it all night till you had a thug. You ain't never had a thug. Bust it down for a girl. Best friend said she only wanna blow. You ain't never had a thug. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. You ain't never had a thug. Wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute. You ain't never had a thug. Come and fuck with a thug, nigga. Only hang around them G's and them drug dealers.
You ain't never had a thug. That was awfully good. I kind of like that.
Appreciate that.
Is that on SoundCloud? How can people listen to
actually,
it?
Actually, that was the only way you can actually play the song. It's on SoundCloud.
Okay.
So, YG and AD's original song is on his on hotnewhiphop.com, mm-hmm. SoundCloud, you name it. It's going to be on iTunes probably pretty soon. I don't know. Mm-hmm. But my remix is on SoundCloud only. You know, you can play it and check, I mean, give me feedback of the song and whatnot. This is just the first time at the West Coast feel, you know what I mean, with the verse and everything. So, yeah.
Well, taking notes from AV, who is a friend of the show, at least you left their verses in there and just added yours because they said that right. You're an artist. So I like that you're keeping it respectful and just adding your flavor.
You know what's so funny?
What?
Since I've been knowing AV for a couple of years now because
right.
He's always been on the show based mm-hmm. on here.
Mm-hmm.
So I forgot to tell you this. I went to Game's performance at Pomona.
Oh, yeah, and the Pomona thing. How was that? I remember you showed me pictures. How was it? But what happened?
Yeah.
He was there?
He was there.
Did he perform?
He performed. Run Me My Money.
Was it good?
Yeah.
The crowd went crazy?
Yeah.
They love that. Something about money songs make people excited. It's like, run me my money, do my money dance, give me my money, bitch better have my money. Anything that got money, it's like that can, you know, pump the crowd up.
Man, yeah.
You need a money song. No, I'm just kidding.
I'm not that type of person that talks about money because that's what everybody's talking about.
I know
but
that.
But I do... But I do have a single out coming soon. I have two singles that's going to be coming out before my album comes. my album drops. One is called Heel Turn 2, Violin. If you haven't heard Heel Turn Burn, that's the first Heel Turn song that's on Laurent's Progression. It's on iTunes, everywhere you name it. Just type in Laurent's Progression, you'll see it anywhere.
Heel Turn 2?
Heel is not the shoes on your feet and like that. It's a wrestling term for a villain. Like, you turn your back on someone. So that's what heel means in wrestling.
How am I a lame, not wrestler watching?
I just let you know. I mean,
and know that
a lot of people don't know that. So that's why I came up with that idea, heel turn. And this one is called Violin. My boy Cushy Carlito, which I mixed and mastered his project with Roach Raps, and I'm very proud of that project. And his project just got on BeRealTV.com.
Oh, that's good.
The other day, so I was just like, man.
You know what's interesting about, like, you know, you're an independent artist, and we're talking to another independent artist if he makes it. I know he's had another appointment, so he's going to come in. But just speaking of independent artists and getting your projects up there, staying consistent with what you're doing is good, because the avenues are opening up, whether it be online radio shows like this one.
Right.
But even I'm going to something tomorrow that Snoop and is that somebody at the door? No. Okay, my bad. Sorry for interrupting. But no, they're doing something. Omar Gooding is a part of it. They're starting their own online channel, and it's called Moda Entertainment. Did you hear about that one?
No.
So yeah, it's like kind of like how Hulu, Netflix, all that. And you know, Apple debuted their first TV show, or are going to, and then I think, you know, so those are things. So I mean, you know, the channels and the way that people see you are opening up.
Yeah.
And you already have such a strong social media following. We're all trying to get like you.
Well, I've just been making moves. Like, I just picked up a verse from Scheme, but I haven't got the verse yet. But I don't know if you heard of Scheme the Duke. That was, he's a games artist from Blood Money Entertainment. So,
you're not going to be throwing up gang signs, are you?
No. Okay, I'm not going to be. No. No, it's just that how this came about. Mm-hmm. I'm going to tell you the story. How this came about, I was actually woken up, and I was on Instagram, and I saw
you
Schemes.
Were woken up by who?
No, I woke up.
Okay, got it.
No, I woke up, and I saw it. I was on Instagram. That was the first thing I went on to. And then.
So, you're one of those. You know how people would just wake up in the middle of the night and check Instagram?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I know not knowing that, because I get like not notifications, like likes and stuff like that. So
you have your notifications on?
Yeah, but I turn them off now. But you know,
right.
Anyways, so I went across Scheme's page, and Scheme's Instagram video, and he was charging. He's willing to collaborate with anybody with a price of his choosing. He charges for the low. From what he normally charges. I think he was like charging $1,500 or something like that. So I inboxed him. Well, DM'd him.
And y'all made a deal.
Yeah, so the deal was, I was like, how much is for a verse?
You don't have to tell everybody unless it's something he told you could share. Because, I mean, you know, prices and stuff like that. He might not get that level.
I'm not going to say the prices, but, I mean, he was just telling me, like, you know. I said, how much for this? And he gave me the price. And I said, how about this price? And then he didn't respond. And I said, how about this price? And he was like, he added a little more, $50 more to the price that I was asking for.
Okay, so Scheme was like running his money, and he got you that verse. That's what's up. So 50 Cent, speaking of rap, I went last week to 50 Cent's, a special screening of the show Power. And all of the creators, 50 Cent was there, Omari Hardwick, Naturi Naughton, a lot of the writers, a lot of Academy members, and they were discussing, you know, the upcoming season.
Right.
And he's really, you know what I know, like 50 Cent is truly a comedian. I wonder why he comes off so funny sometimes on Instagram, like, you know, he's making jokes, but he genuinely has a sense of humor that's actually quite funny.
He's actually a great businessman. Like,
that's what I admire most. I don't always admire how he gets into it with people, but I admire his business skills. He's taken it to a new level from the entertainment perspective, beyond music.
Right. Yeah, because music nowadays that he's doing is nobody's listening to anymore. Like
some of his songs are cool. I think they're over him in some senses, and I think that some of his songs, like he got a song out with Jeremiah that's kind of okay. But I think that when you don't have
a certain rap to me, or rap more so than R&B, is kind of cliquish. Right. You know what I mean? Just like Nicki probably wouldn't have had, as talented as I feel like her music is, I don't think that she would have got the push or any of the fame that she got had she not been down with Young Money, Drake, right. Lil Wayne, and all of that. So I think that in some, like, just like French Montana down with the Rick Rosses and all of that, that whole, it became, because I'm not saying, I'm not bashing his music or whatever, but it's all about your affiliation sometimes. Right. So I think that right now, 50 Cent's affiliation may not be altogether whole, so he may not right. be... I think sometimes it comes off like that. But as a business plan, and as far as what's going on with the show Power, it is doing excellent. It has the highest viewership than any show that's ever been on Stars. And it's expanding. This is his third season, and it's growing. But he made a comment in social media on one of the things. He said that the music business has really tainted his friendships and a lot of his love life. Like, it's hard for him to maintain friendships with people. I think his oldest and dearest friend is Yayo. Hopefully that's not tainted, but pretty much he's fell out with any and everybody from, I think, I mean, never publicly with, say, Eminem or anything, but pretty much he's fallen out with everybody.
Yeah, music industry is, it's like a game of chess. Like, it's a lot of stuff that's like...
Can you play chess?
Not really, a little bit, but not much. Okay. Checkers, I can, you know.
Chestnut checkers.
Yeah.
And then I didn't know, we all knew that Kerry Washington was pregnant, and they said that may have to alter the script because, you know, it just kind of came back, and they said they might have to alter it to either include her pregnancy on there or stop shooting for a little bit just because of her pregnancy. She's having her second baby.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Tatiana Ali's pregnant too, huh?
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
She is.
Mm-hmm. That's cute. That was Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, right?
Mm-hmm. And a lot of people, this has just got in the news. I've been knew about this, but Nipsey Hussle and Laura London is having a baby as well. Yeah.
Wow. A lot of people. That's going to be so cute, though. Are they really?
Yeah. I mean, this was announced like months. Well, I've been seeing on the internet. Because they're really late, but I saw Nipsey Hussle's Instagram a while back. It was like a couple months ago, and he said I'm finally having another baby and all that, something like that. I forgot, but it was so long ago, and then a lot of people are now talking about it. And I'm like, y'all are so late, but yeah.
Well, I'm happy for her.
Yeah.
That's cute. I think that I don't know if I follow her on Instagram or not, but I haven't seen a lot of like. Above head pictures. They're more quotes and inspirational, so maybe she's not trying to give us belly pics. So maybe she's going to bust out on us. That's cute. They're a cute couple. I can't wait to hear some more Nipsey Hussle music. I know
She drops a lot of music every day, I believe.
Where? On the world?
If you go to GangsterRapTalks.com, his name will pop up on certain songs.
GangsterRapTalks.com. It's so many sites to keep up with.
Yeah.
I need to improve my reading list when I do my little research on stuff like that.
That's where I download all the music from. So
what is it called? Gangster Rap what?
Gangster Rap Talks.
Gangster Rap Talks. I have to find out. Because I'm a Nipsey Hussle fan, and I can't wait to see what he's going to do.
Yeah, I actually know Nipsey Hussle personally because his affiliation with, I won't say it's a gang, but everybody knows. But, you know.
60?
From, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I usually live over there, but with my parents and all that, but, you know, but...
Well, I mean, we all know somebody that knows somebody, but, I mean, he's supposed to be coming on the show, and then it never happens, so I don't know. We know a lot of people, but I think he really wants to wait till he's dropping something major. He does do a lot of music, and he wants it to be timely and stuff like that. So I get it, but shout out to Nipsey Hussle and Lauren London for having a baby. But let me get into what I did this weekend, because it was such an amazing experience. It was called the Pink Pump Affair. And the world is our oyster. It was a couture fashion show by Dina Burton, who is a LA-based designer. I can't wait to have her on the show. Her clothes are amazing. They're a couture line. They're based on wearable fabrics. She was the only designer. She was the only black designer to debut at Style Week this year, and it was right there at the Columbia Square, the new center right across from Gower and Sunset. You know that new like little square community, the big tall building across from Roscoe's on Gower. That's called Kola
Mac. Oh, yeah. I remember, they
did a style week there, and it was very high end. She showed, and she got rave reviews. Nice. Her showroom is downtown. I'm really, really excited for her and her line, and just to see her whole collection unfold. And the Pink Pump Affair was a special gala that it was benefiting children with autism and special needs. And the Special Needs LA, where it was headed and founded by the attorney Ariva Martin. And Ariva has always been a champion and a fighter for civil rights and new legislations for special needs children. And she also heads a camp with a parent advocacy for the siblings and parents, as well as, you know, all of those, so it could be a support. Because sometimes sisters and brothers are the caretakers of their, if you have Asperger's or autism. And then she also has, not only does she have the camp, but she has the advocacy. So it was a really, really special affair that honored Layla Ali, and it honored, who else was being honored? Oh, Gail Washington, who is a female woman in the medical community, and a lot of people were on the red carpet. It was commentated by our own Pat Harvey. What is she on, CBS News? You know who Pat Harvey is, veteran news journalist.
I just forgot what I think CBS, yeah.
Mm-hmm. A lot of people came on the red carpet. It was Kelsey Scott, the one that's in 12 Years a Slave and How to Get Away with Murder. Mm-hmm. I saw Sherry Belafonte, New Orleans Saints football linebacker James Anderson and his fiancée, Kim nice. Whitley and her friend, Anna Marie Horsford. She was on that red carpet the whole time, wasn't she? Mm-hmm. I mean, from say, you know how you see, and that's a good thing. I love her to death. But I mean, when I say every time I say her, yes, it was good. So thank everybody. Special shout out to Anthony Turk for making that happen. And oh my God, I have to show you. Well, it was such a lovely gift bag, but it was something. Gerard Cosmetics had some lip gloss, and if this is not the bomb or what, look at this. To all my ladies that are in the club and you know you need a little lip gloss, this is how you do it. Not only is this super cute, right, but then it has a mirror. So say you can't see your lips, you do this and like, them lips is popping. But it's nighttime and you in the club, right, so you can't really see them.
Right.
So you open it and voila, guess what? I'm have my lips lighted. Mm-hmm. Let me get the mirror. So my lip gloss are popping and it's illuminating.
Lightsmith.
So for all you want your lips popping and you want to glow in the dark at night, is Gerard Cosmetics. But it was an awesome gift bag, an awesome event, awesome people. It was an awesome silent auction, and they gave away a lot of good things. And and the Dancing with the Stars, she was there. She's actually going to be at another event tonight. You know what else is going on tomorrow? Before we get into this video, there's an event going on. I told you about the Omar Gooding and that. Come on in. That's him. Come on in. Or is he on that?
No, that's Max Fenton Gray. He's an
anyway,
engineer.
That's not him. He's not for the show. I forgot what I had. You know what I got to do? That's what's going on tomorrow. But tonight, Cynthia Bailey is launching her new leather collection of goods. I was like, this is what I was talking about when I said that all these women get on social media, I mean, all these reality shows, and they just start talking mess to each other about each other and have no agenda on why they're on that show. But Cynthia, not only is her eyewear line doing awesome, but now she has something called Cargo by Cynthia Bailey, and it's an upscale luxury leather good collection where it has backpacks, travel wear, and all of that. So I can't wait to get that. I'm on the VIP, so I'll see that tonight. It's an undisclosed location, even though I'm looking at where it's at, but if you know, then you know. And I'll see you there. But let's get into this video from the Pink Pump Affair and see all the lovely happenings of what happened down there. Cerise Styles here, and we're live at the Pink Pump Affair, the 8th annual at the Four Seasons. Check us out. We're about to go inside.
Benefited from the programs of Special Needs Network, you're going to learn about how corporate America and private foundations are coming together to lift up kids and to lift up community.
I love the Special Needs Network because of all the work they do, especially in underserved communities, supporting kids and families that have autism.
I've been supporting Ariva for years personally because I'm a board certified obstetrician gynecologist. I delivered her daughter Michael, and I am very passionate about this issue because I've seen the incidence of autism change from just a blip in a medical textbook to 1 in 64. And this is a 1 in 64. It's alarming. We don't have the answers. We need to find the answers. But while we're finding the answers, it's important to have the services available for the children presently who are affected with autism.
I have a special affinity for Ariva Martin. She embodies everything to me that is true in a warrior with a caring heart. Ariva not only brings together women in the name of sisterhood, but she also is at the top in terms of getting legislation passed to help people in the special needs community and their families. I have seen her work. I don't know where she gets her energy from. I know she works out, but she is somebody who I know is totally committed, and I'm committed to her because of that. I believe in what she does, and I've been around her long enough to see this is the real deal.
Ever so often you find out something that may be the link, but the missing link has not been found yet. Okay. And I'm really hopeful that that missing link will be found, and I'm sure it's very simple. And it's something all pregnant women are doing that can just be eliminated, and then autism will no longer be an issue.
Part of the assignment, because God gives us the visibility, some people last longer than others. You're using my eyes to see the beautiful world we live in.
Support their causes and bring awareness to it.
And the special need is us being aware that they exist. That's what the special needs are, because as I told the other gentleman, I called this, and this is what I got from that first time I came to one of these things. It's called buried treasure. Because some kids can't talk, some can't see, some can't walk. But God still puts the gold inside of them. The diamond is still there. Nobody's a mistake. We don't have any extra people. You understand?
How do you get ready for the red carpet?
Well, I go through my hundreds and hundreds of skirts from Sophistafunk.
You know, I love fashion. Anybody watch the show? That's been my whole thing. No fashion and comb my hair. So I don't have any magic. When Bonnie said pink pumps, I knew I was not going to give them pink pumps. But I said, oh, I have something with pink on it.
I'm really last minute getting ready. Yep. I didn't know what I was wearing until last night. And I happened to just pull something out of the closet that I hadn't worn before. And what I like to do is just pretty much moisturize my skin. So when I'm taking photos, you know, I'm not looking ashy. I did my own makeup today. Yeah, I just pulled it together.
She does my hair every day. Ed helps me in terms of just, you know, making little decisions. But basically, I did my own makeup today.
One of the organizers, the attorney Bonnie Berry Lamont, she's my entertainment attorney. So I better be here when she sent me a text and say, be here.
That was wonderful, and that was just a small tidbit of what's going on there. And as you see, there were a lot of wonderful, talented women that were there being honored, who I did fail to mention, which was one of the, what do you call that, honorees, and she was given the award by Honorable Mark Ridley Thomas. You know, just as a sidebar, I'm going to come back. Sheila Krull, so I don't want to get away from that. Sheila Krull was being honored, who is one of our legislators. But Mark Ridley Thomas gave her the award. But I find it amazing. I know fathers and sons look alike. It's normal. But when I say, I don't know how close in age they are, but Sebastian Ridley Thomas is his son. And he has a twin. But I almost feel like Mark and Sebastian look like twins. Remember when we went to the Kendrick Lamar thing? I thought I was talking to Mark Ridley Thomas, but he gave me his card, and I was like, that's Sebastian. And I know the difference. I know who each one of them are. I know that they're different people. But when I say that's his son, he couldn't design his, like, that's, they look exactly alike. And they look very, like, similar in age. Like, they could be brothers. So kudos to them genes.
Yeah.
But, yeah, they, you know, just to give you a little taste of who some of their past Oh, and Angeleno Magazine and CBS KCAL 9 were some of the main sponsors, so you will see it. They gave away a Paradise Getaway to the Terrania Spa. They gave away a Vegas-style package where the Boys to Men will be at the Four Seasons Hotel, and it was 2 people, 3 nights stay. They gave a Summer Night's Dream at the Hollywood Bowl featuring Gladys Knight. Then they got Beverly Hills Ballin' at the Montage. You get a 3-night stay. Designer tote, a shopping spree. Then they gave away a wine party for 5. I mean, they had some awesome things. They honored Layla Ali. They honored Gail Jackson and Sharon, is her name? Sheila Krull, our legislator. So it was, and Bonnie Berry Lamont. No, she's the event chair. She's one of the attorneys. But I mean, it's just so many things. So if you want to get involved, you go to specialneedsla.org or snnla.org and just find out more about it. It's an excellent charity event. And I mean, it's a great, she throws annual, she does multiple events throughout the year. Right. So I truly enjoyed it. And everything was wonderful. So let's just see when her next event, but shout out to her. I got my number one ace book, Miss Shauna Aladia. Come sit next to me. No, come on, girl, put some gloss on. See, this how we do. Hey, yes, I was just talking about how I just have these lovely people around me that surround me in my life that I love.
That's awesome. Thank you.
How's your baby?
She's good.
She's good? Okay, good.
My big baby.
Your big baby. Well, they're all your babies.
Yeah.
How are you doing today?
I'm good. I'm tired.
You tired? You always running around. You got so much to do.
You're just as busy.
I know.
Are you going to Cynthia's thing today?
We just talked about that. Yes, we are. We were talking about the Pink Pump Affair I just attended. You just missed a lovely video. Layla Ali was honored. Mm-hmm. Sheila Krull was honored. I mean, did I say her name right? You know me. Gail Jackson was honored. And, you know, it was a wonderful event. But Areva always does a really nice event. I was telling them about the wonderful gift bags that we had. And then I was showing off my Gerard Cosmetics that was in the gift bag. And it has a mirror. And then, so if you're ever in the club at night, you do this. Lips popping.
But wait a minute. That should be on every lipstick.
But then it's lit. So if I can't see, you know I'm a, you know.
That is so cute.
I'm going to get you some. What color? You wear the same colors I wear? Don't
yeah.
You? Yeah. Okay, cool. I got
some. It depends on the day. That is so good.
I love the nails.
Oh, thank you.
Are those mood change nails? Or what's
no,
going
this
on?
Is a like a iridescent. Ombre? Yeah.
Iridescent ombre?
Yeah. So, you know, shout out to Summit Nails on La Brea and Overhill.
That's cute.
It's really snazzy. Nice.
I don't know what I was doing last night. I just got gel a week ago and peeled that shit off. Like, I can't. I got one hand.
Peeling is not good for you.
I know. That's why I don't wear nails or anything, because if I don't like something, I just totally take it off. So are you going to Redberry tonight?
I mean, this?
Okay. So cool. We'll see each other there. That's awesome. And then, since you're here and I wasn't there, I missed Chimoji. I went to something else and I was kind of wore out. I didn't know what to expect. So give us a little bit about what was the Chimoji event, because everybody's launching these apps.
Have you seen her app? It's very cute. She has a lot of cute little emojis on there. Mm-hmm. Some booty shaking, stripper pole ones. Her and Rob are on there, and her pregnant, married wedding dress. So they are actually really, really cute together.
I think that they are. I think it's like anytime someone can be going through something. And what I noticed, like, I rarely watch the Kardashians. I'm just kind of over it for a lot of reasons, but they are entertaining. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So it's nothing bad I have to say. It's not like, oh, I don't like them. But I just, sometimes I don't like keep up with the show. I'm not keeping up with the Kardashians, should say. But if you can't help but see it through other media channels, what I noticed is that a lot of the men don't get their voices heard. And I think that kind of shelters them. And I feel like that's what happened to Rob.
Yeah.
So whatever happened between China and him that made them come together, is that the door thing?
No.
Oh, okay, that's you. Oh, my thing room like that. We do that. But yeah, I was just like, whatever it is, and I happened to be watching it the other day, they didn't already wrote her into the storyline.
Well, that was the whole purpose. I mean, Chris is extremely smart.
She is. We'll give her, that I will give her.
She is a entertainment genius.
Mm-hmm.
She took what her daughter did and capitalized off of. They were already socialites, but my thing is, I think they did push Rob to the back burner, and I don't think they really dealt with a lot of the issues he had with his dad being gone.
Right.
Then, you know, then it's like the man who raised him is now a woman. You know, it's like all these things. And then all the boyfriends that he gets close to.
Girlfriends.
No.
Oh, the males.
The males that the sisters. You
then
know,
they
Lamar,
disappear. Yeah.
Kanye or whoever it may be, they always break up with them. And it's like, now I've lost a brother.
And then they look, it almost feels like the friendship isn't real. It's for TV or for them, because once they go away, the friendship goes away. It's like it's not
well,
there.
Well, him and Lamar are still extremely close.
Oh, they are good.
Yeah, and as far as, I don't know how he is with the Yeah, because he's just all over the place.
So I watched that. He is all over the place. My friend goes to the gym with him, and he's a firecracker.
Mm-hmm.
But what I did see is, I don't know. I lost my train of thought. I forgot what I was going to say about something.
Well, I don't like how Chloe was the number one supporter.
That's what I was going to say. And she dissed him like, that's what I didn't. Go ahead.
Of the brother.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know if they have the how the relationship happened mm-hmm. with Kylie and Tyga.
Mm-hmm.
But how are you mad at your brother for dating
and she
China? And your sister, who was underage, mind you.
And your friend, who was, China was your friend then.
No, she was one of Kim's best friends.
Right.
So who should have gotten checked in this?
And Kylie.
Whose mama should have been checking Kylie as well?
Mm-hmm.
So Kylie is in the dead wrong from the get-go. The sisters, the mama are all in the wrong for even letting that relationship happen. Mm-hmm. But as she said when she went off on them last week, the mother,
mm-hmm.
don't tell me what to do with my son, basically, because I've tolerated everything and supported you guys through everything. She said, Kim, 72 days of marriage? Who does that? Like, she says, so whatever I want to do with my son, I'm going to do it, and you guys stop
like
judging
that.
Me. I know she wanted to say so much more.
I know she did, but it was on camera. They did it for the game. But I don't like how, kind of like, you know, they all have money. They're making money off the show. They're a wealthy family. But they said, don't even help him with his down payment. As if, like, dang, you're just going to blast him? Like, Kim
like
helped
he
all
no
y'all
money.
Make money. Like, you know, she put the bread
Kim
and the butter
last
on the
season.
I think somebody at the door I hear knocking. I don't know what that means, but it's something there.
Kim said that last season about, I think it was Courtney. They said, are you going to get her something for her birthday? She was like, I gave her a career.
Ooh.
You didn't see that episode?
No. I told y'all I'm be keeping up with the Kardashians, but they be like,
sorry,
that's him,
guys.
Huh?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you for having me on for this brief second.
Well, I appreciate you for talking to
this
us. You know,
the book from the thing?
Yeah,
I'm
going to
look at it.
Yeah, look at it. That was wonderful.
Like one of my kids.
I do. I know. I want to, yeah, that was perfect. And then,
you going to segue me up out of here?
Okay, so why don't we go to a Pitbull commercial, cousin, and then... Don't be all she's. No, you know what? Why don't we do this? You got some songs from Kola Mac before Kola Mac get in here. Why don't you? But not Norco. Play is okay. Tear It Down or sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
Can you play one of them?
One of them. I have a music video too.
Well, we gonna play some. We gonna play his single when he get in here. But one of these was not. Just play something for Kola Mac, cause Kola Mac is on his way in here, and we gonna get to talk to him. So we gonna get that video queued up with my lip gloss popping. By Gerard Kurtzman.
So you got two choices in life, nigga. You either eat or you don't. But this volume 3, though. You slow bus niggas still ain't caught up. That's why I don't fuck with you niggas. You know what I'm talking about?
Ain't a damn thing changed, I still had to switch it up. I came back like I left, I still don't give a fuck. I still don't give a fuck, I came back like I left something. But ain't a damn thing changed, I still had to switch it up. I came back like I left, I still don't give a fuck. I still don't give a fuck, I came back like I left something. Nigga,
But ain't a damn thing changed but the switch up. The snakes in the grass are waiting for Kola slip up. I let the yappa blast make a lung pick up. This nigga falling and he can't get tough, huh? I switched it up, I hit the raw with less kisser. The mix the new cut with the fish deserted is up. I switched the routes up, same old pickup. I put on the West Lot and it ain't no nigga. Lil mama stay down cause by now she get the picture. Quick to switch my bitch up, but I come back to get ya. Rappers act familiar, I don't be trapping with ya. Don't be in traffic with ya, not on Instagram, nigga. Unless you talking 2.2 pounds, nigga. Fuck around, do the math, about 1,000 grams, nigga. I'm talking straight yams, nigga. Won't find common ground till you underground, nigga. Ain't a damn thing changed. I still had to switch it up. I came back like I left. I still don't give a fuck. I still don't give a fuck. I came back like I left something. But ain't a damn thing changed. I still had to switch it up. I came back like I left. I still don't give a fuck. I still don't give a fuck. I came back like I left something, nigga. I'm still pitching from the same man. While you debate who you figure holding the crown. To real legitimate paper, come around, I'm off the book straight getting it. Fuck what you talking about. I'm 3 gun cases later, see you still a hater. Probably was praying for that just to fucking hang him. I'm Van Excellent, it's prime, can't contain him. Came back like I left, snatching up what I came from. Cause any nigga ever stayed down, came up. From chop to change up, rocking a little cane up. Switched the whole game up, still never changed up. Was never gauged much, fucking can you blame him? I'm frontin', wasn't ever giving nothing. Had to create something, fuck around, take something. Tuli came off my hip, had to spray something. You try to talk that shit, but you ain't saying nothing. Cause any nigga ever stayed down came up. From chopping change up, rocking a little cane up. Switched the whole game up, still never changed up. Was never gave much, fucker, can you blame him? I'm frontin', wasn't ever giving nothing. Had to create something, fuck around, take something. Tuli came off my hip, had to spray something. You try to talk that shit, but you ain't saying nothing.
Ain't a damn thing changed, I still had to switch it up. I came back like I left, I still don't give a fuck. I still don't give a fuck, I came back like I left something. But ain't a damn thing changed, I still had to switch it up. I came back like I left, I still don't give a fuck. I still don't give a fuck, I came back like I left something, nigga.
Hey, Beauty and the Beat Radio, and we back. I got Kola Mac in the building. Hey,
Kola. How you doing?
Can I call you Kola?
Yes, you can.
How did you get that name? Where is Kola Mac from? Mac Daddy?
Yeah, you know the Mackin is the Mackin.
Are you Mackin and Kraken?
Somewhat. I mean, you know. The Kola is like kind of just my way of saying I'm dope.
Okay, I got you. Because Kola, like Coca-Cola?
Yeah.
But not the Kola part? But the Kola Mac and the Coca-Cola Kola? Kola Mackin'
yeah,
and Kraken.
I
got it.
You got the name. You got it.
And you from the Hall of Motherfucking Fame up in here. I like that too.
That's right.
I love it. So what you been up to? How was your week?
Oh, everything been cool. Just moving around. Shauna keeping me busy.
That's good. That's a good thing. I saw you at the Chai Mochi event. We just talked a little bit about that. How do you like her apps?
Cool.
It's cool?
Yeah.
I don't know if I believed you when you said it because, you know, it was cool. You like it. Everybody got their apps now. They give you a chance to kind of do different things and say different things on without speaking. I think that's what, you know. Yeah. I think some of the new apps you have to cut and paste. So how is hers?
I support her doing her thing. You know, Shona knows I'm just a little behind on the technology.
I noticed you don't even have an IG. I was like, sir,
yeah, so.
I can't, I mean, you know, I can hashtag you, but I was like, am I missing something?
Yeah, so you can imagine I'm not up on the emojis.
I got you. What's up with the lucky lefty? Because we got Kola Mac, but what's lucky lefty mean? Where did
I'm left-handed.
Okay.
Consider myself blessed and lucky, so.
I like that. So, see, it's the purpose behind everything.
I mean, lucky lefty just sounds better than blessed lefty, but, you know. It's just,
you're still blessed.
Yeah.
I feel blessed. I love, you know, what's her name, Riley? Are you watching basketball right now?
Basketball? Yeah, definitely.
Riley is Stephon Curry, Riley Curry.
Oh, his daughter.
You know, she remember when she said, I feel blessed.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know what I'm talking about. I went real left on you. Like, what's she? Is she trying to sing? No, I cannot. Who's on your, okay, so besides yourself, who's on your playlist? Who do you like to listen to? Who are you inspired by musically?
I mean, coming up, you got Snoop, Cube, Quick. We go East, Nas, Jay-Z, Biggie. I mean, you say Pac, but you don't really have to say Pac. I mean, but now, I just started really getting into Pusha T's album. I hadn't really heard it. Like I said, I'm slow on technology, so I can go on my phone and stream it through my speaker. So I've been listening to Pusha T's album lately.
I like Pusha T. You know what I was kind of surprised about is, I keep mentioning Revolt, because Revolt really has interesting musical programming to me. And they did his... What's his brother's name? Because I know I'll mess it up. But he has a brother. Malice.
So well, it's No Malice now.
It's No Malice. So he did a documentary of just their whole coming into the industry. And just, it gave me a whole nother perspective. I've always liked the clips. But, I mean, it just, individually. So I like Pusha. I'm a fan of Pusha T, too. So.
He's been going for a minute. So I've been feeling what he's been doing on the solo thing.
Well, I'm feeling what you've been doing. I heard you have some samples in there. It kind of gave me the old school with the new school feels. Like, you know. I like that. Yeah, I like you. So you're influenced by a lot of R&B, old music, or classic music. I shouldn't say old music. Classic music influences as well.
Yeah, '90s era kind of raised and molded me. So when I create, that's kind of where I draw from.
You grew up in West LA. Where'd you grow up in? Are you from LA? That's where did you grow up?
Yeah, I actually grew up like 3rd Avenue 67th in LA. I went to Audubon Middle School.
Okay.
But, you know, I like this area, that area, but really this area, though.
This area? You like this area? How important is it to have your city behind you as an artist?
It's important. It's real important. It's a must. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you got to do your thing and make them catch up, too.
Right.
Yeah.
Do you have a lot of support in the neighborhood when you put out your mixtapes? I'd say it's a lot of buzz going on for Kola Mac.
Yeah, I mean, we got support. We always could use more. Mm-hmm. We're always looking for more. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, everything's good.
So you got a mixtape coming up right now?
We could call it that. Another project coming, Eat or Don't, Volume 3.
Eat or Don't. Yep. Why did you name it that?
Two choices in life.
Eat or Don't.
Yeah.
It's either survivor or the fittest, kind of?
Yeah, that's kind of my saying. Got two choices in life. Eat or you don't.
Eat or you don't. Okay, so I was watching one of your videos.
Which
and
one?
Don't ask me that right now, but we're going to show it. But it was saying, no, you were going into a deli. The girls were licking ice cream and stuff, and they was kissing on you and happy that you were there. But you were just talking about, you know, you had some, it took a lot for you to get your freedom. So it was like something that was going on in your music. Like it seems like it's been a lot that you've been through in your life. Does your music reflect that?
It does. We had a few legal setbacks throughout the years, kind of like some... be right there, something about to happen, and then
something
set back. But we, you know, we push through it. We still here.
So your music is a reflection of what you're living every day.
Yeah, living, seeing, feeling, my perspective.
So I see that you work with a lot of artists. I mean, I look Waka Flocka, French Montana, Lil Zane. Does that say YG? Hootie?
Hootie.
YG Hootie.
Joe Moses. Roscoe, Umali, Dollar, rest in peace, who's on. They were talking, that Love and Hip Hop Atlanta. I can't. You don't watch it? Do you watch reality shows? You gonna tell me you behind on that soon?
I mean, somewhat.
You watch Atlanta?
Somewhat.
I mean, what is it called?
Somewhat scrapping them on there. They kind of from the area.
They from your area?
Yeah, they got ties. They have ties to us.
Who?
Scrap and Dollar.
From Atlanta?
Yeah.
Oh, I know who you're talking about. Oh, Dollar, the one that passed,
yeah.
And then his family. So they have ties to Los Angeles.
Yeah.
Even though, are they originally from here?
They were kind of back and forth. You can kind of say that, but they have ties with us. We're close, like family.
Oh, okay. So you knew what was going on. What happened with all that around that time? That was just an unfortunate situation?
Yeah, just an unfortunate situation.
That was all bad. And then Meech Wells, that's a producer. Right?
Meech.
Okay. So, you work with a lot of people. What kind of performances have you been doing?
We just did South by Southwest a couple months ago.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. So, I've never been to South by Southwest. How is that? What was that experience like?
That was my first time. It was a cool experience. We politic, met a few people. Mm-hmm. I only did a couple shows, but it was cool.
What was the vibe like there? Because sometimes it's all about the energy. I mean, you got to perform, you got to introduce your music to new crowds, new people, new fans, new audiences. They got to know who you are. But, I mean, what was the vibe like musically? Because, I mean, it's so many people. It's like, what, a week-long festival?
Yeah.
So what was going on? What else
I mean,
going
it was
on
a lot going on. Like, I used, I'm not sure if you were hip to a New York artist named Graf. Mm-hmm. Queens, you know, mm-hmm. Grab. Yeah, I used his DJ because my DJ couldn't make it. Deftone couldn't make it.
Okay.
And even just hanging with them, like, they kind of was like, I mean, he had shows going, but his DJ would go run up in the spot and holler at the dude, and next thing you know, he performing.
Right.
Like, he was just kind of like, he had book shows, and mm-hmm. I was just watching different people, how they get down. It was just cool just being in an environment, seeing the way different people move.
So I think that's interesting, because I think we were just talking about music. LaRon himself is a music artist, a hip-hop artist.
Okay.
And I think that with the way that distribution is going, the outlets to be seen and heard are growing so fast that if you're ready, you never know when that opportunity is going to come. Okay. So you're messing with a DJ, even though he's a new DJ, he's showing you love, like, hey, I'm about to perform, you go open up for me. And then yeah. It might be 10,000 people in there. That's 10,000 new people that may not have heard from you.
Right.
So that's excellent. We want to get into some of your music. What song do you want to play? We got Norco. We got Tear It Down. Norco is your new single off Don't Eat or Don't. So
yeah.
Would you like to play that?
We could go into Norco.
Why did we name it Norco? Because isn't that a drug?
It's a pharmaceutical. Have you heard it yet?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You know, party so hard, I might need a Norco.
Got it.
Might
I need one. I get migraines. Shout out to my doctor for keeping me.
That's for the hangover. Headache.
I got a headache. Shout out because I need a Norco. Just kidding. Let's play that. Introduce it. Did you introduce it?
It's my new joint, Norco, featuring my boy Pimpin' Silky.
Off of Eat or Don't, Volume 3.
Coming soon.
Right.
By the way, I'm going in tonight, nigga. Might need a Norco. You know what I'm talking about?
Damn. I'm so cold, left that hoe by the North Pole. Party so hard, might need a Norco. We mix the Douce with Rosé, ho. Going ham, bitch, pause on the pork, though. We going ham, bitch, pause on the pork, though. Mix the Douce with Rosé, ho. I'm so cold, left that hoe by the North Pole. Party so hard, might need a Norco. Party so hard, might need a Norco. I'm so cold, left that hoe by the North Pole. Cause she was tripping, that's a no-go. She wasn't with it. That's a no-go, fuck outta here, I'm loco. That body banger, give me Ocho. I'm on a ride with that Quattro Cinco. My lawyer holler, what you think though? So fuck you mean, 5 years to the district attorney that I don't think so. I hear no evil and I see no. Until the day my cannon's aiming at your peephole. Take this, back to business, more fish, more bricks. My Persian bitch got a cold remix. You been exposed, you are not with the shit. I know you wearing them shoes that say they fit. You folded it up and just took it on the chin. Same nigga claim you running a sex, stop flip. I'm so cold, left that hoe by the North Pole. Party so hard, might need a Norco. We mix the Douce with Rosé, ho. Going ham, bitch, pause on the pork, though. We going ham, bitch, pause on the pork, though. Mix the Douce with Rosé, ho. I'm so cold, left that hoe by the North Pole. Party so hard, might need a Norco. I'm low. Bitch in mind, would pop a pill, but it go. Tryna trick it, call that shit a G3-0. Pippin need my rain, super snow. I'ma show you, bitch, how to be a stomp down hoe. Whole time by the molly pop. Better hit the track, bitch, and gonna let the panties drop. I need mine like a crack spot. I'm to my big knots. Bitch, drop it out your cock sock. Bitch, run up on me, talking about daddy, I just got robbed. I said, well, look here, bitch, that's the jack of money. Now go get mine, ho. You funky, knock me, drop my bitch. Hey, man, this Pippin Silky, man, fuck it with my player partner, Kola Mac, man. I'm just maintaining my campaign, posing to get chosen around this motherfucker. You funky, bitch. I'm so cold, left that hoe by the North Pole. Party so hard, might need a Norco. We mix the Douce with Rosé, ho. Going ham, bitch, pause on the pork, though. We going ham, bitch, pause on the pork, though. Mix the Douce with Rosé, ho. I'm
so cold, let that hoe by the North Pole. Party so hard, might need a narco. We going hammer, I am. Looks 90%, cause child put me in the mix. Sniff, remember life's a white bitch. Let them hoes party hard, we should not wipe them. Show. She holla, tell me when to go. But look, mama, I need all 10 toes. We mix the douce with rose, ho. That's that new thug passion. Drink up, ho. Don't say too much, don't touch nothing. Up until you see my Ferragamo belt unbuckling. They show me something, we out here trying to function. Or duck and crash, fuck that gang injunction. Got the homies out, tooly up, bustin'. It's nothing, the whole wicked side make it rain. I'm talking less showers, let it rain. Big C came home, now free the homie Trey Bang. But I'm so cold, let that hoe by the North Pole. Party so hard, might need a narco. We mix the douce with rose, ho. Going ham, bitch, pause on the pork, though. We going ham, bitch, pause on the pork, though. Mix the douce with rose, ho. I'm so cold, let that hoe by the North Pole. Party so hard, might need a narco. Go.
Hey, man. You know, motherfuckers around here, man, pause to get chosen, bitch, if you didn't hear it the first time, bitch. Huh. See about it, you funky dog here, bitch.
We go whole, what is it? It's I go ham, song. Go pause on the pork, go.
You should have played Switch It Up. That's what you should have played.
Switch It Up, then. Then we got Switch It Up up in here. Oh, we that was first. See, you late. Let's play Switch It Up one more time. Before we go out, we're going to play Switch It Up. Then we're going to tell people how they can find you, how they can follow you, okay. Because you're only on Twitter. But give them your Twitter handle right now.
Facebook.
Oh, and Facebook. I'm sorry. Kola Mac on Facebook. It is a nice little Facebook page. Excuse me. And tell them how it's at Kola Mac on Twitter. Lucky Lefty.
KOLAMAC at Kola Mac.
Because he got that macking and cracking going on. And it sounds like he got that pimping going on with Pimping Silky on the track. Talk, need all 10 toes and 10 fingers, bitch. Hoes down. Pimps up. Okay, let's get into that. What's that? What you want to play right now?
Switch It Up.
Switch It Up. We're going to switch it up on him because we're not pausing on him. We damn near need a Norco up in here, but not quite.
Might need them.
Do you have any upcoming appearances coming up? Where can we look at? We know how to find you on Twitter, Facebook, and the Webosphere. What you got coming up?
We got some things coming up. You kind of have to ask Shona, though.
Okay, well, I'm going to ask Shona, because Shona's the woman to know. Miss Shona Aladia. Mm-hmm. Manger. Yeah.
So you got two choices in life, nigga. You either eat, or you don't. But this Volume 3, though. You slow bunch niggas still ain't caught up. That's why I don't fuck with you niggas. You know what I'm talking about? Ain't a damn thing changed. I still had to switch it up. I came back like I left. I still don't give a fuck. I still don't give a fuck. I came back like I left something. But ain't a damn thing changed. I still had to switch it up. I came back like I left. I still don't give a fuck. I still don't give a fuck. I came back like I left something. Nigga. But ain't a damn thing changed but the switch up. The snakes in the grass and waiting for Kola slip up. I let the yappa blast make a lung pick up. This nigga ballin' and he can't get tough, huh? I switched it up, I hit the raw with less kisser. The mix the new cut with the fish deserted is up. I switched the routes up, same old pickup. I put over West Lock and it ain't no nigga. Lil' mama stay down cause by now she get the picture. Quick to switch my bitch up, but I come back to get ya. Rappers act familiar, I don't be trapping with ya. Don't be in traffic with ya, not on Instagram, nigga. Unless you talking 2.2 pounds, nigga. Fuck around, do the math, about 1,000 grams, nigga. I'm talking straight yams, nigga. Won't find common ground till you underground, nigga. Ain't a damn thing changed. I still had to switch it up. I came back like I left. I still don't give a fuck. I still don't give a fuck. I came back like I left something. But ain't a damn thing changed. I still had to switch it up. I came back like I left. I still don't give a fuck. I still don't give a fuck. I came back like I left something. Nigga. I'm still pitching from the same man. While you debate who you figure hole in the cram. To real legitimate paper, come around, I'm off the book straight getting it. Fuck what you talking about. I'm 3 gun cases later, see you still a hater. Probably was praying for the judge to fucking hang him.
I'm Van Excellent as prime, can't contain them. Came back like I left, snatching up what I came from. Cause any nigga ever stayed down, came up. From chop to change up, rocking a little cane up. Switched the whole game up, still never changed up. Was never gave much, fuck it, can you blame them? I'm frontin', wasn't ever giving nothing. Had to create something, fuck around, take something. Thule came off my hip, had to spray something. You try to talk that shit, but you ain't saying nothing. Cause any nigga ever stayed down came up. From chopping change up, rocking a little cane up. Switched the whole game up, still never changed up. Was never gave much, fucker, can you blame him? I'm frontin', wasn't ever giving nothing. Had to create something, fuck around, take something. Tune came off my hip, had to spray something. You try to talk that shit, but you ain't saying nothing.
Ain't a damn thing changed, I still had to switch it up. I came back like I left, I still don't give a fuck. I still don't give a fuck, I came back like I left something. But ain't a damn thing changed, I still had to switch it up. I came back like I left, I still don't give a fuck. I still don't give a fuck, I came back like I left something. Nigga.
Up on you because we didn't want you to think he was all about that pimping and stuff. You know, we was talking about dream collaborations and stuff. We was talking about maybe doing something with DJ Quick. We putting it out there in the air. Put it out there like a collaboration. So, I mean, you've collaborated with a lot of people. You have some great music out there. I love both of the songs we heard today. We did we show the video? Why you didn't do it?
I mean, you wanted to play the single.
Oh, show the video while we're going out, and then that's what we're going to go out to the video. But I appreciate you, Kola Mac, coming by today. I want everybody to follow Kola Mac on Twitter, Facebook. Keep out for him. Check out that Eat or Don't Volume 3 coming out with Norco. You might need one. And then switch it up on him. What was the other one we just heard? Now we're about to see the video, right? So you got a lot going on. Congratulations, much success.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
And I can't wait to come see you live or something. And thank you, Shona. I appreciate you. I appreciate you. We about to go out to the video. Introduce it for us, cause we're going on Beauty and the Beat Radio.
Here's my video. Another record off Eat It Don't Volume 3 coming this summer called Sometimes.
Sometimes it be like that.
Shit. Eat It Don't Volume 3. You know what I'm talking about? Sometimes I goes in, sometimes I falls back, nigga. But at no times will I bend, break, fold, or crack, nigga. Well shit, if it's on and it's on, tool up and let it crack, nigga. They claim I'm under fire, reply, I bust back, nigga. But still, sometimes I goes in when I should fall back. Bailing out the county jail, bouncing back. Few new charges in front of me. Won't let niggas front on me. The Lord said, know thyself, it's only one of me. Violation merged with my case, still a gun on me. 20K to be free today, niggas don't want that with me. Chopping change one, niggas can't fuck with me. Banging my set, blocking my blessings, fuck is wrong with me. Flew out the NY to meet with Lenny. Tito scooped me as I land, my BK niggas. Left Crown Heights to Manhattan, lightweight business. I puss it all up in they face, so you can't miss it. You see it, that I'm the truth, hands down, don't even play yourself. Jump off a roof, nigga, go ahead and bang yourself. While still my old shit, pay for my help. My son growing, I desire wealth, I'm busting back, I ride for self. Sometimes I goes in, sometimes I falls back, nigga. No times will I bend, break, fold, or crack, nigga. Well shit, if it's on and it's on, tool up and let it crack, nigga. They claim I'm under fire, reply, I bust back, nigga.
One of Napoleon's generals, the other Napoleon, came to him one day and they were fixing to attack the next morning. His general says, sir, the conditions, the circumstances are not just right for the attack tomorrow. And Napoleon says, circumstances not right, hell, I make circumstances. Attack! And I have never seen a successful man yet in any business that didn't say when somebody says it can't be done, he says, attack! Attack! Start where you are. And when you get that curve in the road, although you can't see by it until you get there, you'll always find that the road goes on around. Attack! Don't procrastinate, don't stand still. Attack! Attack!